I'm Doug Doyle with The Art of the Story. Acclaimed author Paul Alexander has just published a new book about the life and death of Billie Holiday. It's called Bitter Crop, The Heartache and Triumph of Billie Holiday's Last Year.
All of me, why not take all of me? Can't you see I'm no good without you?
WBGO's Lee Mergner spoke with Alexander about what may be the definitive biography of the legendary singer, the result of enormous research and numerous interviews.
What did you learn about her that surprised you? Something or some things that you just really didn't know until you got into it?
We have this image of her, particularly based on all the other, it's essentially the movies, really, the two movies. But some of the other biographical stuff, that the last year of her life, it just sort of, she was just walking around in a drug coma and then she died. That wasn't what I found at all. She was incredibly active. She was still doing gig after gig after gig all over the country. And I was able, you know, because we were advancing so much in research engines that just normal people can access, like newspapers.com or newspaperarchives.com. They have vast, you know, holdings that in all these small town newspapers. And so you can really access that. It's a public thing, you know, it's just, you pay for it. And so I was able to go find all of the gigs that she had played during the last year. A lot of them hadn't been written about before. Like, for example, George Wynn always told everybody that her run at Storyville in 1959 was the, in April 1959 was her last gig. Well, it wasn't. I think George wanted it to be her last gig. So I had Billie Holiday's last gig, but like a week or two later, she played a club in Lowell, Massachusetts. You know, but you get a sense of just how driven she was, even at the end of her life, even with all the illnesses that she was dealing with, how she had to keep singing. As Catherine Russell blurbed my book, and she said, what really stood out to her was that she just had to sing. She couldn't stop singing. Mm-hmm. And I guess if you're a singer of that caliber, that's what happens to you. You just can't stop.
You can hear Lee Mergner's entire conversation with author Paul Alexander at WBGO.org. I'm Doug Doyle, WBGO News.